Hello dear participants, I am Dr. Archana Kaushik, faculty at the Department of Social Work, University of Delhi. Today we would be discussing the topic old age care. Let us start with overview of aging in India. The composition of the world population has changed dramatically in recent decades. The human population is growing and with it concerns about the aged have been growing. Care and protection of the elderly was integrally embedded in our value system. With the advent of modernity and globalization and accompanying phenomena such as industrialization, urbanization, migration have put strains on social institutions, which are wilting and changing fast. Even as birth rates fall steeply, improved healthcare systems have contributed to unprecedented longevity levels. The challenges of taking care of the elderly are now increasingly faced by countries, especially the developing nations. In both developed and developing countries, there has been a shift in age structure of aged population. The issues and problems of the elderly population are a matter of deep concern and pose a developmental challenge. The next topic for the discussion is on magnitude of the aging in India. As per 2011 census, total population of senior citizens, that is people aged 60 years and above, is 10.38 crores, of which population of males and females was 5.11 crore and 5.27 crore respectively. The number of senior citizens in the total population is highest in Uttar Pradesh, which is 15.44 crores, followed by Maharashtra, 11.10 crores, and Andhra Pradesh, 8.27 crores. The Lakshadweep with 0.05 crores has the lowest population of people aged 60 years and above. The details of percentage share of elderly population by residents in state and union territories as per the census 2011 has been provided in the slide. Let's talk about the problems and challenges of senior citizens. First of all, we would discuss about the health problems, and to begin with, deterioration of health and strength is the main characteristic of old age. As people age, the bone density lessens and can sometimes reach a point where an action as simple as standing up or sitting down can cause a fracture. It is osteoporosis. This usually happens with the old age group who are in their late 80s or 90s. Arthritis is perhaps the single most common ailment of afflicting older persons today. Roughly about half of all adults aged 65 and above suffer from this condition to some extent, and the joint pain it causes can erode the retiree's quality of life. About one third of all men and a quarter of all women in this age category suffer from some sort of chronic heart ailment. Those with high blood pressure and or cholesterol levels are at higher risk of heart disease than others. Just over one third of men and women, 40% of women between the aged 65 and 74 are considered to be obese. So, obesity is one of the most important ailment that affects the quality of life in old age. And this risk factor can lead to heart disease, cancer, diabetes and other chronic conditions. The most commonly abused substances among senior citizens are alcohol and tobacco, which can interact in unhealthy ways with any prescription medicines that are being used. It can also lead to greater risk of injury from falls or tripping. Let us talk about mental health issues. The elderly people grapple with several major common medical ailments such as Alzheimer's disease or another form of cognitive impairment, which can require constant supervision and care by either a friend or family member or healthcare professional. It is dementia. Depression can affect senior citizens in many ways, such as by lowering their immune systems and by making them vulnerable to diseases. Many senior citizens who live alone can't spend enough time interacting with other people, and loneliness can be overwhelming for some of them. Then there are financial issues. First one is poverty. Nearly 2/3 of the elderly are in poverty in India. Poverty accelerates aging, and the problem of aged people face. The rate of poverty is slightly higher among elderly women than males. And of course, those who live in poverty have much harder time managing their basic survival needs and affording medical treatment. Then there is lack of financial planning. Millions of people are retiring without seeking advice from the financial planner about how to handle their retirement benefits and other savings, and they may end up becoming victims of financial abuse by their significant others and by strangers. This may lead to financial crisis. Next is running out of money. This goes hand in hand with poverty, but many senior citizens simply do not have sufficient savings to tide them over during retirement. Many of this dilemma are forced to go back to work in some capacity, which can be very hard for them in their later years. Fraud is another one. Many seniors are very trusting people, and hucksters often prey upon these type of persons, pretending to be their friend in order to get them send money for some goods or services. Low interest rate is the another one. Senior citizens who are previously relied on income generated by fixed income investments have a hard time finding decent yields in recent years. Then fear of stock market is there. Many of the senior citizens remained in low yielding investment that have substantially lagged the market for the past several years. Social security funding is another point. The Social Security Trust Fund is expected to be depleted by 2033, and at that point, seniors may be forced to absorb a reduction in benefits of over 20%. This is alarming news. Considering the large segment of seniors who rely on Social Security as their primary or sole source of income. Increasing healthcare costs is another point. The cost of healthcare in India is rising at a much faster rate than the overall rate of inflation. There is poor job market. Seniors who have no retirement savings and need to re-enter the workforce will find themselves at a disadvantage, as many employers are looking to hire younger employees who will work for a lower rate to pay. Then there are family issues, and assisting adult children is an important point. A recent report from PEW Research Center reveals that almost half of seniors who are aged 60 or above were helping their adult children to pay their bills. Statistics show that this trend is substantially impacting the level of assets of the elderly. Living with adult children, parents who can no longer care for themselves often move back in with their adult children. This arrangement can be dicey in some circumstances, where the parents or parents must have to adjust the role of receiving care instead of giving care. Now let's discuss the constitutional provisions for the welfare of senior citizens. The Article 41 of the Constitution provides that the state shall, within the limits of its economic capacity and development, make effective provisions for securing the right to work, to education, to public assistance in cases of unemployment, old age, sickness, and disablement, and in other cases of undeserved want. Now let us know about the salient features of the Maintenance and Welfare of Parents and Senior Citizens Act 2007. This act was meant to ensure the needs-based maintenance for parents and senior citizens and their welfare. The Act provides for the maintenance of parents or senior citizens by children or relatives made obligatory and justifiable through tribunals. Revocation of transfer of property by seniors in case of negligence by relatives. Penal provisions for abandonment of senior citizens. Establishment of old age homes for indigent senior citizens. Adequate medical facilities and security of senior citizens. Well, in the next and the last topic, we are going to talk about policies, programs and schemes for the welfare of senior citizens. The first one is National Policy on Older Persons, which was announced in 1999 to reaffirm the commitment to ensure the well-being of the older persons. The policy envisages state support to ensure financial and food security, healthcare, shelter and other needs of older persons, equitable share in development, protection against abuse and exploitation, and availability of services to improve the quality of their lives. Then comes National Council of Older Persons. In pursuit of NPOP 1999, a Council for Older Persons was constituted under the chairmanship of Union Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment to oversee the implementation of the policy. The NCOP is the highest body to advise the government in the formulation and implementation of the policies and programs for the aged. With a view to have a more definite structure, the NCOP was reconstituted and renamed as National Council of Senior Citizens. Next point is Maintenance and Welfare of Parents and Senior Citizens Act. This act was passed in 2007 to enable senior citizens abandoned by their children to claim maintenance. This act was passed to provide maintenance support to elderly parents and senior citizens. The Act established the maintenance tribunals to provide speedy and effective relief to elderly persons. Section 19 of the Act also mandates the establishment of an old age home in every district and provides for the protection of life and property of the elderly. Integrated Program for Older Persons. Under this scheme, financial assistance up to 90% of the project cost is provided to government, non-government institutions, panchayati raj bodies and local organizations, etc. for establishing and maintaining old age homes, daycare centers and mobile Medicare units. The scheme has been revised with effect from 1st April 2008. Besides increase in amount of financial assistance for existing projects, several innovative projects have been added as being eligible for assistance under the scheme. And some of these are maintenance of respite care, homes and continuous care homes, running of daycare center for Alzheimer's disease, dementia patients, physiotherapy clinics for old persons, helplines and counseling centers for older persons, sensitizing programs for children particularly in schools and colleges, regional resource and training centers, training of caregivers to the older persons, awareness generation programs for older persons and caregivers, formulation of senior citizen associations, etc. Then International Day on Older Persons. Every year, the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment observes the International Day of Older Persons on 1st October. A morning walkathon is organized at Rajpath, India Gate to promote intergenerational bonding, wherein more than 3000 senior citizens from across Delhi, NGOs working in the field of elderly issues, and school children from different schools participate in this event. On the day, Vayojaratha Samman awards under different categories are conferred to elderly and institutions who have done outstanding work in the field of elderly care every year by Honorable President of India. The event is being organized every year with objective of recognizing their contributions, outstanding services by Social Justice and Empowerment Government of India. Then Rashtriya Vayoshri Yojana. The scheme aims at providing senior citizens belonging to below poverty line category and suffering from any of the age related disability or infirmity such as low vision, hearing impairment, loss of teeth and locomotion disability with such assisted living devices which can restore near normalcy in their bodily functioning, overcoming the disability or infirmity manifested. The assistive devices shall be of high quality and conforming to the standards laid down by the Bureau of Indian Standards wherein feasible. Then the programs of other ministries may be looked into. Ministry of Health and Family Welfare provides the following facilities for senior citizens of separate queues for older persons in government hospitals, geriatric clinics in several government hospitals. Then ministry implemented the national program for the health care of the elderly, that is in acronym known as NPHCE, from the year 2010-11. Ministry of Finance provides tax benefits and health insurance facilities for senior citizens. Ministry of Home Affairs in its advisories has advised the states and union territories to take immediate measures to ensure safety and security and for elimination of all forms of neglect, abuse and violence against older persons through initiatives such as identification of senior citizens, sensitization of police personnel regarding safety, security of older persons, regular visit of the beat staff, setting up of toll-free senior citizen helplines, setting up of senior citizen security cells, verification of domestic help drivers, etc. Ministry of Rural Development, under this ministry, the National Social Assistance Program, NSAP, was launched. One of the components under NSAP is Indira Gandhi National Old Age Pension Scheme, in which rupees 200 per month per beneficiary to BPL persons is given who are in the age group of 60 to 79 years and rupees 500 per month to 80 years and above. Ministry of Railway provides the following facilities to senior citizens. Separate ticket counters for senior citizens of age 60 years and above at various passenger reservation system centers if the average demand per shift is more than 120 tickets, provision of lower berth to male passengers of 60 years and above and female passengers of 45 years and above. 40% and 50% concession in rail fare for males 60 years and females 58 years senior citizens respectively. Wheelchairs at stations for old age passengers. Ministry of Civil Aviation. The national carrier Air India under the Ministry of Civil Aviation provides airfare concession up to 50% for senior citizens who have completed 63 years of age on the date of commencement of journey and on production of proof of age, photo ID and nationality. Department of Pension, it has set up a pension portal to enable senior citizens to get information regarding the status of their application, the amount of pension, documents required, if any, etc. The portal also provides for lodging of grievances. As per the recommendation of the 6th Pay Commission, additional pension will be provided as per the details given below to older persons. Then Department of Communication, it has made special provisions for senior citizens who apply for new telephone connections. Ministry of Law and Justice, it directs the High Court in the country to accord priority to cases involving older persons and ensures their expeditious disposal. With this, we come to an end of this session. Thank you.